Assalamu alaikum and hello everyone. This is Kashif Kamran and I welcome you to the Online Lecturer Academy very first virtual meetup with Tuta, where our expert tutors will be discussing the December 2020 exam results and will be giving you the guidance for the upcoming March 2021 exam setting. Now, today I have with me my expert panel, which will be giving you guidance on the March 2021 exams and will be interacting with you if you have any questions during the session. I would first like to introduce Mr. Hussain Kazi, who is the co-founder of the Online Lecturer Academy and is our expert tutor for strategic business reporting, advanced financial management, and the financial management paper. And he's been teaching this for the last 14 years. I'm also joined by Ms. Zaira Anis. She is our expert tutor for performance management and advanced performance management, and she is teaching these papers since last 14 years. I'm also joined by Hamad Vora, who is our expert tutor for financial reporting, and he's teaching the financial reporting paper since over 3 years now. And I'm also joined by our TEX expert, which is Mr. Shahnawaz Ahmed, who teaches the TX paper and the ATX paper from the Online Lecturers Academy. And it's been over 14 years since he's teaching these papers. I welcome you all to this virtual meetup with tutor session. Okay, first of all, before we get any questions from the student, I would like my panelists to go in order. And let's start discussing in journal what has been the overall results of the December 2020 exam sittings. Let's first start with Mr. Hussain Kazi. Sir, if you can just spend some time on spelling out the December 2020 exam sitting.
Thank you very much, Kashif Saab. As Kashif Saab mentioned that I'm a facilitator for the SBR, AFM, and the financial management exam. So one by one. About the SBR exam, Kashif Saab, it's all about the result status. That's we can say that it's maintaining the legacy of the examiner about the given marks. That's the radius of the 50%. Once again, the percentage of the SBR exams, that's about the 47% of the total 100% out of total 100%. So, what I can say that 47% is a very good result in the AGC exam. And it's the norm of the SBR. Normally, since September 18, the exams continuation or the results continuation with respect to the marking aspect with the radius of the 50%. Although one of the time of the exams since September 18, the result goes up to the level of 52 or 51%. But what I can say that it's a norm result. It's a result what normally we expect. Second one about the AFM, the optional exams, as you know very well, you are also the expert of the optional exams, that's AAA. Normally the ratio of the result of the AFM exams under 40%, but this time, fortunately, it's 40%, 40 plus percent, that's equals to 42% of the results. It's very amazing. Since September 18, it's historical. Very fortunate result. It's a historical result at the upside. So I must say that students who are planning to give the exams for the March and the June, so try to get this opportunity because the tendency is good upward. Because the past history shows that the AFM results normally go upward and then at the moment, at some particular moment, the exam team pull out the result with under 40%. So this is the right time to appear for the exams. So overall, the result is good for the AFM. And normally the AFM about the skill module results, it's under 45%, it's 43%. So overall, the results are predictable, except the AFM results more than percentage, that's 42%.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. Hussain Kazi. Now over to Ms. Zaira Anis. Can you share your feedback about the December results, particularly the PM and the APM results?
Yes, sure. Thank you, Sir Kashif, for providing me this opportunity. Actually, APM result was 32% this time, and broadly it's around 32-33%, basically 31-32%, and it's consistent in last from last several attempts. So I personally believe that there is no such improvement, not such decline in the result. So I personally believe that results are consistent. There is no such change. Although PM paper has shown some improvement because that was around 40% instead of 36, 37, 38%. So it shows a little bit improvement, but I believe that more or less passing percentage is same as compared with the previous semester. So I'm not seeing any improvement or any problem with this result, with the semester result, considering the case that there are a lot of students who attempted CBE paper, computer based paper, and remote examinations were there. Still, passing ratio is maintained quite and it's stable.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much for the feedback, Ms. Zairani. Sir Shahnawaz Ahmed, what about the feedback for TX and ATX for December 2020 exam settings?
Thank you, Sir Kashif Kamran, for giving me this opportunity to discuss the result and the overall situation about the exam. First of all, let's talk about the paper taxation. As taxation is a type of paper which is not that much difficult when we talk about the fundamental papers, that is from F5 to F9, right? And the overall result is usually in the range of 49 to 50% always. This time it is almost the same, and it's for December 2020, it's 51%, which is quite good results. And almost every student I thought is almost get the 50% passing marks at least. So overall result is good as far as TX is concerned. And as far as ATX is concerned, let me just share you the a bit detail of the past exam. In March 2020, the result was 44%. And then in September 2020, the result was a bit declined and it was 38%. So there was a drop of 6% from March 2020 to September 2020. But now the current result of December exam is 40%. That shows some minor recovery, but it is still behind the an average, which is like 42, 41, 42%. So we can say that it's not bad. It's not good. It's not bad. It's a conventional result. And having said that, the paper is difficult. Time management is one of the issue with that paper. So students usually get this type of result overall.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. Shahnawaz Ahmed. Now over to Hamad Bora. Hamad, what is your input on the results for December 2020, particularly for the financial reporting paper?
Yes, thank you so much, Sir Kashif Kamran, for having me. The FR paper has shown a rather fluctuating results. Now, if you look at the past, in 2019, the results were averaging at 45%. You talk about September 2019, you talk about December, you talk about even March 2020, it was somewhere around 44%. Now, suddenly in September 2020, the result went up to 50%, which gave a bit of a positive vibe that yes, there might be certain changes and this the students might be passing this exam with a higher percentages now. But again, in the recent attempt, we can see the percentage came back to 48%. The overall pass rate came back down to 48%, which reflects the fact that in FR, we haven't seen for the past couple of, past 5-6 attempts, that the result is going above the average of 47. So we can understand that there are certain areas which we need to focus on, which we'll be discussing later on.
Okay. Thank you very much for that feedback. Now, just before I put another question to my panelists, I just want to share the result for the AAA paper, the AA paper, and the SPL paper, which currently I am teaching at the Online Lecturers Academy. Now, in terms of the AAA result, the AAA result was quite average, though we saw an improvement of 2% from the last exam sitting in September 2020, where the passing rate was 33. It improved to 35% in December 2020. So for the AAA, it was quite a high passing rate because 35% of result was last time achieved a year ago. So after a year, we are looking back the same good results for AAA, which was 35%. But on and off, it was an average result for the AAA paper. For the AA paper, the passing percentage declined globally from 41%, which was in September 2020, to 39% in December 2020. Audit papers, whether it is the AA paper or the AAA paper, continues to be a challenge for the student community, primarily being a theoretical paper. And we believe that theoretical paper is a paper where students generally underperform over the numerical papers. For the SPL paper, the passing rates for SPL are healthy. Even though we have seen a 2% decline in the SPL paper, the passing rate of SPL was 51% in September 20, but it declined to 49% in December 2020. But on average, a 50% passing rate for the SPL paper, and I think the same is for the SPR paper, more or less, that's quite healthy in terms of considering these are strategic level exams, which needs a very significant input from the student. So that's the overall feedback being shared by all my panelists. So let's put on another question for discussion with all our panelists. The other question which I would like to discuss with all of you, anyone can start first in order, and then we keep shifting. What were the main pitfalls when it comes to student failing in the strategic professional level exams? I would like to hear from all of you that what are basic reasons, irrespective of papers, why students fail at a strategic professional level exams, particularly the strategic optional exams, particularly Ms. Zaira, the APM paper, Sir Hussain Qazi, the AFM paper, and Sir Shahnawaz Ahmed, the ATX paper. Why students struggle in these papers?
I wanted to point out some concrete point about the AFM. First of all, actually, the students are not preparing the paper according to the examiner expectations. And what are the reasons, one by one? What are the specific reasons? They are not meeting the expectation. I must say that the ACC optional paper requirement for the quality standard to qualify the exam, it's much higher as compared to the previous studies of the ACC. If we analyze the situation, the only optional exams were normal results under 40%. Kajitab, not even SBL, not even SBR. Mm-hmm. So that means you have to enhance your quality standard. Let's suppose a student qualify the exams of the SBR, having the radius of the result 50%, SBL having the radius of the 45-47%, and comes to the optional paper, and preparing for the exam where the result under 40%. So that means the quality of answers should be increased. That's a key point.
Agree.
So another point, how to improve the quality? The key thing to improve the quality is to involve with the exam questions. Mm-hmm. Whatever the guideline or the direction provided by the tutors have to apply and simulate the exam. It's not only about the practice, it's about the simulation. Simulation means you have to attend question in a manner that, like you are sitting in the examination hall, stop the just switch off your mobile phone, stopwatch, connect the stopwatch for the one, for example, 50 marks question, 90 minutes, and start working. And you feel that you must have to practice the question in a manner that you are sitting in the examination hall and evaluate your situation. What's the reason? What and time by time you have to improve your structure. And do remember that growth is always in a manner, not in a straight way. First question you will attempt it, you will improve your situation. Maybe the second question, your performance become declined, but don't demotivate. You keep moving. The important thing is keep moving. The key point, the most important, another key point. Number one, simulation. Number two, whenever you're sitting in the examination hall, don't make up your mind that I have to put the 100% accurate thing in the examination hall. Rather than I have to complete an appropriate 100% exam. So exam day key point, focus on 100% appropriateness rather than accuracy. During preparation, the exam simulation. These are the key two things where the chances of your pass will definitely enhance. All of the instructor here, Ms. Zahira Nees, Shahnawaz Saab, and Kashif Kamran, we are associated with the Platinum Status College. And we have been teaching with more than a decade, more than 12-year experience, more than 14-year experience. So we have been observing the same situation, that the students who are engaging with the exam simulation and practice in a manner and attempting the mock exams, they have a brighter chance to qualify the exams. That is my point. Over to other.
I agree. What about APM paper, Ms. Zahira Nees? What are the reasons why students fail?
Sir, I personally believe whenever I ask a student that what do you think that why you flung in the paper, because students know what they did in their paper. So majority students have no idea why they flunked. They say that, ma'am, we wrote 100% things right. The paper went really good and we really don't know why we flunked. I personally believe that there are 2 to 3 things broadly. The first thing is time management, as covered by Sir Hussain Qazi, that simulation is very important. You have to practice question with considering the time per timing perspective so that you can have the examination time pressure. Second thing, which is very important in APM, is the lack of understanding in the requirement. Because in APM, there is an embedded requirement in the question. For example, examiner will ask you one major requirement, and within that requirement, there are 2 or 3 requirements. For example, the CEO wants you to tell him what is the benchmarking, and then what are the types of benchmarking available, and what is beneficial for the company. So you have to answer 3 parts here, not just write what is good for the company. So students sometimes miss these things. And then the most important thing, which I believe in APM paper, is the justification. Justification in the sense, I have checked so many copies where students write that economic value added is beneficial for the company if company wants to have long-term value addition. But they don't write why they think that EV is important, why they think that relative market share is important. So that why factor is always missing in their paper. Why they think that current situation is not good, what the company is currently practicing is not good, and why the new method should be adopted. They just write that this is that company should adopt this. So that why factor is important. The third thing, which is really important, is what I think Sir Hussain Qazi said as well. Marking scheme is really important. Students don't study marking scheme. They don't have any idea about marking scheme. They don't have any idea about examiner report. And it's like you are working in an organization. You are working really hard for your bonuses and you don't know on what factors your bonus is based on. So I personally believe that is very important to look at what points are actually contributing towards the marks. That is really very important. And one more thing in APM paper that they, whenever examiner introduce any new concept, examiner wants its introduction. That usually student miss. They start with writing the answer. They miss that introduction part. So these are 3 to 4 things which I believe that APM paper require, especially that justification and time management part. That's my key point.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much for that insight.
I want to interrupt and one more thing important. Student, sure. That's already emphasized by the Zahira Nees. If you people are write anything in the exam for the optional paper and even for the SBR and SBL, and if you're writing some knowledge aspect, for example, AFM, there's a concept of the synergy. If you're writing something about synergy, it's not possible to qualify your exam until unless you have to connect the that particular concept with the case. So that's the professional behavior, the expectation from the examiner from your side. That's a professional behavior. Whatever the knowledge required by the examiner, you have to connect with the case. That's a key point.
Totally agree.
And don't get rid from the theoretical aspect of the exam. Analyze the exam about that, how much examiner examined the theory in the paper, and you have to prepare in a balanced format. Normally 50% of the AFM part related to theory, 50% calculation. Let's suppose you are next 5 weeks, you are spending 100 hours of your studies. So you have to balance 50 for theory, 50 calculation. Normally what a student do that, they are very much comfortable with the calculation. So 80% time is spent for the calculation. So yes. how he or she become able to attempt the paper in that aspect, that exam, to meet the examiner expectation. Thank you, Kaj Sahab. Over to Shahnawaz.
Thank you very much. Sir, Shahnawaz Ahmed, what about ATX paper? What are basic pitfalls in ATX paper? Why students fail in ATX paper?
Well, first of all, the most important thing, which Mr. Hussain Qazi and Ma'am Zaira was also talking about, that is the time management. And I do believe that it's very, very difficult paper in terms of time management, because most of the student, when I talk about how much they have attempted the paper, the usual the answer is like 80% and 85%. So if you are not able to attempt 100% paper or close to 95%, then there are likely chances that you are not able to get 50 marks. And this is the reason why majority of the student get 45, 46 and 42 marks. So it's obvious recommendation. So do try to work on time management. Try to work with your tutor. Try to practice in terms of time management, because if you are not able to attempt the entire paper, then you're likely to fail. That is the main reason, number one. And number two is, which is a very, very key impact, also written in the examiner reports always, that the ATX paper is based on the TX paper. The ATX paper is based on the TX paper. If you can see the examination report, the syllabus, so the entire TX syllabus is part of ATX syllabus. Now, one of the drawback is that the student usually attempt TX in a different finance act, and when they attempt ATX, there will be a different finance act, because there is a difference of around 1 and 1.5 years. So, and there are lots of calculation, and taxation paper is all about memorization of tax rules. So if you are not able to recall the taxation, then how you can apply in the ATX exam? So if you see in the examination question, there are lots of easy marks, but a student is even not able to get the basic marks at how to calculate income tax liability. Students are always trying to work hard on the difficult aspects of ATX, but the examiner is also giving you the easy marks in terms of the basic capital allowance calculation, in terms of the basic income tax calculation. And I usually surprise when the examiner asks about the exact TX things, which is always asked by examiner in TX exam. And even student, if they are not able to get those marks which are being asked previously in the taxation paper, then it's a big fault on their side. We do try to cover the whole taxation paper in our ATX lectures, but it's up to the students that they have to give the weightage to the basic requirement, the basic the taxation requirement in their ATX paper.
Okay, thank you very much, Shahnawaz Ahmed. I would like to take the input of Hamad Bora on the financial reporting pitfalls. What are general reasons why students fail in the financial reporting paper? Because we already have student questions as well. So once Hamad, you complete, so I'll be asking the student questions to the panelist. Over to you, Hamad.
All right. The primary reason which we have seen, which causes a student to fail in FR, somewhat related to what my colleagues have already mentioned, that time management is not there. And one question, particularly one point, Sir Hussain Qazi pointed out that they're running away. In fact, you even pointed out you're running away from theory. Now I'm coming to that. We understand, the student understand that in an FR paper, one question is always about interpretation and an evaluation of financial statements. An analysis of financial statement is there. Now, student, they do calculate the ratios. That area is much more covered compared to the interpretation part. Now, each attempt, there are students who fail to properly give the interpretation. either they define the ratio, that what the ratio is, but they fail to connect the dots. Now, the whole point of this exam is that you connect the dots, you understand why a certain thing is happening. And the good thing is that everything is mentioned in the case. So you'll understand this once you read the case properly. And this question always comes in the section C of the examination paper. So you know that, for example, in the last attempt, it was this analysis part question was for worth 11 marks. Now, if a student fails to properly analyze the financial statements, it fails to explain why this happening, he or she is going to lose the marks. Similarly, certain areas which require attention is that a lot of times what we have seen that students are failing because they lack knowledge in even the basic of the accounting standards. For example, one accounting standard is thoroughly, almost in every diet, is examined, and that's IS 16. Now, I've seen examiners comments that even in IS 16, students fail to recall that if there's a reversal, what value we are going to restrict it to. But then there are certain standards which students, every time they're unable to answer it properly, that's like, for example, government grants. Then a lot of time examiners have pointed this out that if, for example, a treatment of a particular area is requested, students generally make an accounting entry, but they fail to explain why, how we're going to treat it. Now, you do get marks for the general entry, but you don't get marks that would help you in passing. So what we can gauge from here, the students need to understand two things. You cannot ignore understanding what the accounting standards are telling you, because examiner can ask you anything. Number one, that's really important. Number two, you cannot ignore all aspects of consolidation. You can't just say that I've practiced goodwill in this attempt, I might pass because of I have practiced goodwill. No, the examiner can ask you something else as well, as far as consolidation is part of your syllabus. And it's in fact tested every time. The examiner usually asks for a standalone financial statement, preparation of standalone financial statements. And the observation is that students fail to properly adjust the entries or the notes which are given. Why? Because they lack the understanding of the accounting standards. So these are the key areas where students need to focus. A, they need to really study on the accounting standards. Two, they need to understand that calculation is not the only thing. They'll have to give interpretations and explanation of what is required. Otherwise, the chances of passing are really thin. That is from my side. Thank you so much.
Totally agree. Thank you so much, Hamad Vora. And just I'll be taking 2 minutes for the AAA paper before putting the student questions to the panelists. Now, in terms of the AAA paper, as rightly pointed out by Hussein Kazi, Ms. Zaira Anis, Shahnawaz Ahmed, in terms of the strategic professional papers, more or less the same problems are with the AAA paper. But just to add on, AAA being a pure theoretical paper with very less involvement of the calculations in a certain exam setting, the students should identify their weak areas, that is how they develop an answer, how they develop a point. Because generally, when you are explaining your answer, as Ms. Zaira pointed out, the why is missing. You're not writing the why. And till the time you don't write the why in your answer, you're not scoring that full one mark. Because to score that full one mark in a theoretical paper, your justification is very important, or your basis is very important, or the decision you are taking, because you are a manager in the AAA paper. So your decision has to be supported with some logical assumptions. A lot of times the student take hypothetical assumptions, which makes their decision useless or baseless. So you need to take sound judgments in the AAA paper to pass. And then more importantly, something I've been encouraging on a very regular basis is the reading of the examiner reports, which students don't do it. I believe all of you must have seen the December 2020 examiner reports for all papers. The ACCA has changed the format of the examiner reports from December 2020. They become more user interactive. The examiner reports are now better looking, and it's giving more to students. I think even the AAA examiner report this time, that was like 20 pages of the examiner report, which is far better than reading the examiner answer, because it gives you so much and it's so interactive that they've given the hyperlinks. If the examiner wants you to take you to somewhere, the hyperlink is given there. You just click on the hyperlink and you go there. So make a habit of reading examiner reports, because that will give you a very constructive feedback of your weaknesses in the AAA paper. That's very, very important. Okay, now towards the last phase of our Facebook Live session, the meetup with Tutor, I have some questions which I'd like to be addressed first before raising some more discussions among our panelists. There is first question in order. That question came from someone whose name is unknown, asking for tips for SPR, please. So over to Hussain Qazi, if you can just briefly share the tip.
The tips for the SPR. So in a broader context, SBR having five areas of the syllabus. Number one, the knowledge of the accounting standard, number one, first thing. Number two, the other project of the accounting standard board, that's conceptual framework. Number three, the current development related to accounting standards in the conceptual framework, number three. Number four, the ethical aspects and related to the financial reporting issues. And number five, the first four thing is about the mindset related to the maker of the financial statement. But the fifth one, the SBR fifth topic, is with viewpoint of user of the financial statement. That is performance measurement. These are the five areas. That's why the paper, first of all, think about it. Why the name of the paper, it's not AFR. The important thing is that develop your mindset. No, develop your mindset. You people are not even developing your mindset and start preparation. So develop your mindset. The advance of the FM, it's AFM. The advance of the TX, ATX. The advance of AA, that's AAA. The advance of PM, it's APM. The advance of FR called SBR. What the reason behind it? The reason is that your point of view with respect to or the examiner expectations, it's not only about that you deliver with viewpoint of use, as a maker of the financial statement, but also with viewpoint of user of the financial statement. That's a part of the performance measurement. The key for the preparation of the SBR, I must say one word, that is called SBR 360. What is that SBR 360? Normally, you people prepare these five areas of the syllabus in an isolation manner. Okay, prepare in an isolation manner, but your examiner examine the things in a very integrated way. For example, if there is a question about the leases, so examiner will definitely connect with the performance measurement of the leases areas, not like F7. But the areas of the performance measurement with viewpoint of the investor. Examiner will also connect that particular standard with the conceptual framework, with the current development. So normally students perform good when independently something examined. But this is not the challenging area. The challenging area is that how to integrate the knowledge with these five areas. So I must say that if you are preparing your exam, so you must have to regularly interact with your past papers, immediate past papers. For there are two sections, section A, section B.
Okay.
Section A is comparatively predictable, but section B, it's not much predictable. It's very challenging. What's the reason? The reason is that section A question one, that's group accounts and some other part of the syllabus, predefined. Section A question two, standards connect with the ethical aspects. But the section B part, it's open-ended. It's accounting standard, it's conceptual framework, performance measurement, a lot of areas. And do remember that SBR, it's not about the only accounting paper. It's not about the calculation. You will face just maximum 8 to 10 marks, maximum 8 to 10 or 12 marks related to calculation, rest of the aspect of the theoretical. These are the key areas. And for all the exams, mark my words, always prepare for the worst situation. Always prepare for the worst. If you consider that, sir, normally theory examines 20%. You must have to prepare in a manner that a calculation will examine 20% marks. You must have to prepare in a way that 10%. If examiner asks more than 10%, that will be the bonus for you. So that's a test for the SBR. Otherwise, you can contact us on the Facebook or the WhatsApp for the more detailed aspects. Even we are going to start some SBR 360 by the name of SBR 360. With students normally make a challenge about it. A short duration course as well.
Fine, thank you. There is another question which I need to address in order. That's a question from Muhammad Adnan asking that he flunked at 49 in AAA December exams. Please suggest me what to do in March 21. Again, you need to follow some systematic approach. First, download the examiner report for December 20, see where you went wrong. Practice the recent past papers. And if you didn't got the opportunity to get your paper checked by a tutor or marked by a tutor, please assure Muhammad Adnan that you get your script marked by a tutor so that you know where are the problems. Read the examiner report, get your script marked by a tutor, do the recent papers, and please ensure there are 5 technique articles on the ACCA website, part 1 to part 5. I hope you must have read that for even December 20 exam setting. Please revise them again, because these are very fundamentals if you want to get 50 and plus 50 in the AAA paper. And there are many other questions for AAA, so I'll be addressing them as well. So you will be getting a better answer by the end of the session. Okay, there is another question. It's a very general question. Any one of you can handle this. It's a question from a student, Hilda. She's asking, is it too late to start preparing for March exams? I don't know which paper is she asking, but a journal question. So Ms. Zaira or Shahnawaz Ahmed, you want to comment on that? Is it too late for starting for March exams preparation? No idea which paper.
Well, if she's talking about taxation or advanced taxation, then it is strongly advisable not to go for it, because these papers are too lengthy in terms of covering the entire syllabus.
Fine. And what about APM, Zaira? If she's preparing APM, for APM, then?
See, APM is a lengthy paper, and you need a lot of practice with respect to practicing the theoretical part and just writing those things in order to practice. So I believe if she is full-time student, she can. But if she is working, then I think it will be difficult for her to manage. And also, if she has attempted it before, then she can manage. If this is the first time, then don't do that.
Fine. Thank you. Okay, there is another question. I'll be taking on my areas in the end, so I can give you the chance first to speak. There is another question, Hussein Qazi. This question is from Ankita. She's asking, I am giving my AAA and AFM exams in March. Please, could you give me some tips as to how I can manage my time effectively and allocate between the two papers, AAA and AFM in March? How can she allocate time?
Straight answer for this, you have to split the preparation time 40% for the knowledge, 60% for the exam question to get idea about how to handle the exam. If you allocate the 100 hours of the studies for the AFM, 40% related to the knowledge and 60% time related to the practice question. If you really want to attempt for these three papers, because time is very much limited. I don't know if you are a full-time student or not, but practice in that manner. And do practice the recent exam paper. And I will second the point of Kashif Kamran Saab. You have to read the report, examine the report of the December 20 as well. All of the students must have to read the examiner report, because even it's your first attempt, but you will identify that how the previous students normally made the mistakes. So you will be able that to get the idea about that, what the examiner expectation about it. So ACCA optional exams required quality answer. That requires time management. And I already discussed earlier, exam simulation. Split your preparation areas, theoretical and the calculation accordingly. That's the point.
Okay, thank you. There is another question. This is from Tongai. He's asking, with the time left for March 21, is there enough time for me to take on the SPL together with AAA? I would strongly say no. SPL and AAA together in March, with the less time remaining, I don't have an idea. You started preparing before the result, or you started preparing after the result. In any case, SPL together with AAA is a very, very challenging combination. And you should only take them if you were well prepared or you started classes too early for both of them. But if you started classes late or you plan to start them after your results were out recently, I would not suggest going with both the papers together. Choose one of them for the March exam sitting. Okay, just before I take further questions, Hamad has been silent panelist for a long time. So I just want to raise another question to Hamad. Hamad, if any student is preparing for March 21 for financial reporting, can you give him some tips to pass the financial reporting paper in March 21?
All right. That depends on two factors right now. One, is the person giving a reattempt or is it the first attempt? If it's a first attempt, has the person started off yet or not? Because that's important. The reason it's important is that we can practice. It's not that you cannot practice, but it requires time to understand the accounting standards. So if someone is giving a reattempt, you know that you have a familiarity with the accounting standard, the basics of the accounting standards. So now you can revise the standards, focus on the practice area. Because even as Sir Hussain Qazi pointed out that at this point, when you are standing on 22nd of January, you should focus more on practice and less on the knowledge area. Agreed. Now, without the knowledge area, the practice is not that feasible. And in my opinion, someone who's going to attempt FR in March, your first way is first go through a particular topic. Your syllabus is divided into topics. For example, go through a particular standard, attempt the practice question and timed practice question, just like a simulation. Then go to pick another accounting standard, go through the accounting standard, attempt the questions. Everything is there. First, you attempt the questions. Once you have covered a couple of standards or you have covered the syllabus, start attempting past papers altogether. Time. That's the only way you can prepare right now, but you need to put in, because you're standing on March 22nd, and I believe, or January 22nd, I believe 4th March is the attempt for FR.
Fine.
So we have somewhere around 5 weeks before the exam starts.
Agree. Totally agree.
So thank you so much from my side.
Fine. Just to continue with the question, Tongai is putting that focus again that, by the way, I'm not a full-time student. So if you're not a full-time student, then taking two papers for March is totally difficult. Just go for one. And I think you mentioned in your earlier comment, which I missed out, that you flunked in your AAA exams in December. So I would prefer that you reappear for AAA in March. That would be better. Defer your SPL exams for June would be a better combination for you. There is one more question because we are also running out of time. So I want some more questions to the panelists as well. So I just want a quick feedback from Hussain Qazi on this question. There was a question from a student asking for, there's a question from Osama Nasir. Is there any recent published article or a current issue we should look for in the SPR paper?
About the SPR technical issues, as I already mentioned that there are five components of the syllabus area. So you must go to the ECC websites for the current issues of the SBR technical articles. You will identify the current articles related to SBR. You will have identified. But moreover, rather than, you have to select the current issues matter from your study decks, like the Kaplan, one of the chapter related to the current issue. Take out the matter from the Kaplan. What the related current issues exam team mention, that's by September 20. That will be examined for the December 20, March 21, and the June 21, the related current issues matter. And you just go through the Kaplan book and also suggest that you must also spend some time for the internet surfing to get the general idea, to get the general idea. And I will take 30 seconds more for this. Do remember the important thing related to current issues of the SBR that examiner never expecting any in-depth knowledge of the current issues of the SBR. The in-depth knowledge of the current issues. For example, if something is going to change, it's mentioned on the current issues related to the financial instrument, debt versus equity. A very complicated case. So because some discussion paper, it's under cover related to ISB and ACCA, consider that the current issue. So you just go through the knowledge related to the current issue. Just go through the knowledge of the current issue. Examiner never expecting the in-depth knowledge. They're expecting that you have just initial knowledge about it. So another point is that previous current issues, for example, the IS-19 related matter, that will not examine again. So you must identify that from the exam document or from your study text, what are the relevant current issues. Read the articles. You can also identify the current issues from my YouTube channel as well. At least 2 to 3 current development related to December 20 exam and also applicable for the March 21 and June 21 as well. You can identify.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. Hossain Kazi. Just another quick questions because we are running out of time as well. We need to wind up with some very key tips from all expert tutors, how students should prepare for March 21. There is a question for you, Ms. Zaira. The student, I think the name is Saddam, is asking, APM has a very low pass rate. Any guidance for someone preparing for June 21 and hoping to pass first time? And he's also resitting AAA at the same time as well. So he's more concerned about APM low pass rates and he want to pass first time in June. What guidance will you give to him?
All right. June, that means the student has around 4 to 5, 4 and a half months. So I believe that there are four or five things which he must do. The first thing is that try to practice at least 5 or 6 attempt papers. That is really very important. And when I'm saying practice the paper, consider two things. The first thing is simulation. And the second thing is you have to write all those answers. You cannot read the question, and write some key points that I will write this and then go to the next question. You have to write the question properly in a proper format, especially that 50 marks question. You have to write it in a proper manner. Second thing, read, have a look at the answer scheme on what grounds examiner is actually giving you points. Read examiner report and build a habit of writing the justification. That's really very important. And if you are writing any general answer, that's not going to earn marks. You have to connect it with the scenario. So I believe the key point is to write the answer and practice as many past paper as you can, especially the latest past papers.
Fine, thank you. Thank you very much, Ms. Zaira Anis, for that. Again, I would request all my tutors that once this Facebook live session ends today, there are lots of queries which could not be answered during the live session. But please take your time out of replying to these queries over the online lecturer Facebook page so that the student feel part of this session. So if you can just take a time out after the end of the session today and reply to the student queries pertaining to your subjects. Just before I take a final word from each one of you, there is a question coming from Godfrey asking, hello, sir, I sat for the AAA and SPL 2 times. SPL, I increased from 19 marks to 45 marks, which is incredible. While for AAA, I increased from 5 marks to 43 marks, which itself is incredible. So perhaps on the same journey, if you give the third exam sitting, so hopefully you will surpass 50 in both the exam papers. So I think you should have confidence. You should be optimistic. From 19 to 45, so next exam sitting, hopefully it will be 50 plus. And same goes with AAA, it's like 5 to 43. So hopefully you might be a place winner in the next exam sitting if that trend continues. Right? So I wish you best of luck, right? That's the only thing I can say. I think you are on the right track. You just need to focus and just be optimistic. You will pass in the upcoming exams in March. Okay. Just a quick word from all the panelists, giving each one of you a minute to speak. Starting from Shahnawaz Ahmed again. Now you are the silent panelist since long now. So Shahnawaz Ahmed, what is your key tips for ATX paper and the TX paper for March 2021 exams? What do you want to tell your students appearing for March 2021 exams? Just under 1 minute. I think your mic is muted.
Now it's fine. Well, first of all, let's talk about the taxation paper. So can you hear me right now?
Yes,
we can.
So let's talk about taxation paper first. So it's very important in taxation papers that you should memorize the key dates, because there are lots of marks in terms of memorizing the dates, and especially one or two key areas which student usually face that those are areas are difficult, and examiner are exploiting these areas, such as the tax administration of individual and corporation, as well as tax losses, and there are the group aspects, as well as the pension aspects as well. So try to cover the tax loss rules of these areas particularly. And the thing is, ATX is concerned. So in ATX, because you have to practice as well as you have to cover the tax rules. So first of all, just try to wrap up all the tax rules, because if you're not able to recall the tax rules, it is what you are trying to apply, because you have to apply the tax rules. You have to advise in terms of what are the tax laws. So try to just
I think
there are some technical issues with Shahnawaz Ahmed's voice. Okay, in between, we can just take on another quick reply from myself and Hussain Ghazi. A combined question. There is a student, Eddie. I flunked in AAA second time with marks like 40%. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. Should I reappear or should I go for the AFM paper in March 21? Just a quick word on this.
I don't think so that you have to move from AAA to AFM. Rather than you have to focus on that thing, that's what the mistake you have made in the previous exams. Especially you have to read the examiner report. So focus on that, reiterate accordingly what the reason, because the marks it's under 40. So Kashif Saab will provide you more better guideline that how to improve your marks to 40, rather than you just refresh about all the things and go for the AFM matter. I don't recommend you.
Yes, obviously, I totally agree with Hussain Ghazi. It's a very unwise strategy that you fail in a paper and you change the paper. You have put your time, you've put your investment, you've put your efforts in one paper, and 40% is not a very bad failure. You just need to rethink and you just need to rebound from where you lost ground in the AAA paper, and hopefully your next exam sitting can make you successful in the AAA paper. But it's totally wrong that you fail a paper and you change a paper. So never do that.
So okay. Don't use option for this purpose.
Exactly. Agree.
Don't use option for this purpose.
Totally agree. Okay, just one more reminder. Sir Hussain Ghazi, there are lots of questions for SPR and AFM. Please kindly take time out and respond to them after the session ends today. I think there are questions for me as well, AAA and SPL. I'm also thinking that just to give an encouragement to students, we can do what is that we can have a focused like a 30-minute session with our tutors. That would be like one focused meeting on APM, one focused meeting on ATX, one focused meeting on SPR. I think in that case, we can respond to many questions of the students. Currently, it's happening that the questions are coming in a very good flow, and it's difficult responding to all of them in the constraint of the session time we have. Okay, now just before we end the session today, any advices any one of you wants to give for students, anything you want to add on towards the March 2021 exams?
I think so. Anyone? That Shahnawaz Saab must have to complete the...
Yes, bilkul. Shahnawaz Ahmed, if you can complete your analysis of the...
Yes, I was just talking about the advanced taxation paper, and it's very important that if you want to complete your paper, it's very important that you should cover your entire tax rules. Because if you don't know about any particular tax issue, then you're not able to highlight any of anything up in the exam. Even you cannot write a single line if you don't know about the rules of income tax or any corporation tax issues. And try to identify that what areas are usually being asked by the examiner. And then try to solve many questions on that. Because this paper, this is a quality of that paper that more you practice the same question twice or thrice or four times, you are able to memorize the tax rules. And the key is to memorize the tax rules. Because if you know the tax rules, then it's very easy to apply that tax rule on a given examination situation.
Totally agree. Thank you very much, Shahnawaz Ahmed, for that insights on the ATX and TX scenario. I think what our tutors have added today, Hamad Vora, Hussein Qazi, Ms. Zaira Anees, and Shahnawaz Ahmed, and myself, would help you all rethink your March 2021 exam sittings and would really benefit you. But again, just a constraint of time. So I think we should come back with focused tutor session, which can give you a better opportunity to interact with tutors on a given subject matter. And again, our tutors will be responding to your queries you have raised during the Facebook live session. So don't worry about that. And our tutors will be connecting with you within the next 24 hours over the comments you have dropped today. Just one confirmation, Ankita, she was asking a question where Hussein Qazi and myself was responding to her, that she wants to take the AAA and AFM papers together. She is making a statement clear that she is a CA final student from India, and she thinks that she's conceptually strong on subjects. So with enough practice, is it possible to tackle both the AAA and AFM together? So before I give opportunity to Hussein Qazi, my answer is yes. See, every student is different. Every student needs to do a self-analysis. You are a weak student, you are an average student, you are an above average student. So what I'm getting out of your statement, you seems like an above average student. So I think handling both the papers together sounds good for you. Over to Hussein Qazi.
Same situation. You have a good knowledge based on your CA studies. So focusing more on the practice. But do remember that you have to prepare your mind that this is not the examination of the CA India. It's ACCA structure. So you have to practice the question in a manner what the expectation of the ACCA exam. That's the key point. So simulate the questions. You have a good knowledge, focus on the practice of the question in a simulation manner.
Totally agree. I just want to give an opportunity to Hamad Vora as well. He's planning some short course on financial reporting for helping students out. If he can just shed a minute on that financial reporting course for the student benefit.
Yes, thank you so much, sir. What we are doing is that we're going to launch a short course, somewhere around 35 to 40 hours lectures that would be all recorded. So what the course would be like, the course would give an overview of the standard and would focus on practice a lot. So it's primarily beneficial for those who are either self-studying or have, or this is going to be a reattempt for them so that they know the depth of this of the syllabus. We're going to give an overview and then we're going to practice. Another key feature of this course would be that fortnightly, we're going to have a live session with the students. So if there are any queries, they can ask me. We'll have a 30-minute to 60-minute session after every 15 days. So we can interact with each other, understand what's going on, which areas to focus on, what you guys need to improve in order to pass the exam. Another thing that that I'll be connecting with all the students on WhatsApp. So if they have queries other than that, so they can also connect with me on WhatsApp. So we'll be launching that, and the promo for that would be coming shortly on our Facebook page. Thank you so much, Akashif.
Okay, that's great. I would just like to affirm that stay tuned to the online lecturer group and the Facebook page for updates coming up for crash courses for March 2021 exams. And we have opened admissions to June 2021 exam sitting as well for all papers offered by Online Lecturers Academy. So if you are interested in availing the June sessions, the admissions have already opened and the March crash course will be coming up. We took your feedback through poll, and the results of the feedback through poll was amazing. So we are planning the crash courses, and I think within the week time, you will get to know the admission process of the crash course coming up for the March 2021 session. So stay tuned for that. And please ensure that you are on the online lecturer Facebook page and the group, so you are timely updated of all the promotions and all the events Online Lecturer Academy is planning for all of you. Just one quick reminder, and I need a affirmative from Hussain Qazi as well on that before we wind up the session. It's almost time that due to the COVID financial distress globally, Online Lecturer Academy has taken an initiative of offering you discounts on fees. For a single paper, we are offering you a 25% discount. And on if you avail two papers from our academy, we are offering you a 40% discount. We do believe that due to the COVID, the financial situation globally is not very good, and which is putting a lot of burden on students' pocket as well. Hussain Qazi, if you want to add something to this.
It's already mentioned about the Kashif Kamran that we are offering the crash courses accordingly. We will offer the APM course as well, a short course for the exam focus for March 21 by Mizar Anis, for ATX by the Mr. Shahnawaz Ahmed for the short course, practice base for March 21 exams, and I will conduct the SBR by the name of SBR 360, where more focusing about the connecting the things, where the student facing the challenge, and the AFM course based on the exam techniques. So these are the courses, and these short courses will be announced by the next 1 week accordingly, and you will get the pre-recorded lectures, including some live sessions and the support by the WhatsApp as well.
Okay, thank you very much. And thank you very much all our panelists for joining our very first virtual meetup with tutors. This was the first Facebook Live session the Online Lecturer Academy was doing, and we'll be coming with more such sessions in near future. Thank you very much, Hamad Vora, for taking time out and participating in this session and sharing your expert opinions about financial reporting. Thank you, Mr. Hussain Qazi, for taking time out for this session and sharing your expert opinions about AFM, SPR, and performance and financial management. Mr. Shahnawaz Ahmed, thank you very much for your time as well and shedding your emphasis on ATX and TX paper, where you are an expert tutor. And thank you, Ms. Zaira Anis, for taking your time out, being our performance management expert tutor, and sharing your thoughts on PM and APM. Thank you. Thank you all very much for taking your time out. So this is the end of the session, and our tutors will be responding back to your queries on the Facebook comments. So don't worry about that. And we wish you all a very best of luck for your upcoming exams in March 2021. This is from all the panel of Online Lecturers Academy. Take care. Allah Hafiz.
Allah Hafiz.